one's name. It's Carmen. Carmen. And you know what, Lydia? Just forget about the dress, okay? We can just tell everybody that Carmen's Puerto Rican. And it never occurred to you that she might be built differently. Or that unlike you and your daughter...
That's America Ferrera in the film The Sisterhood of the Traveling Pants. The actress also made a name for herself on the hit TV show Ugly Betty. Now she's stepping behind the camera as executive producer of a new Netflix series. The bilingual comedy Gentefied tells the story of Mexican-American family trying to keep its business afloat in a gentrifying East Los Angeles neighborhood. Ferrera talked to our Mireya Villarreal about combining her love of storytelling with her passion for her Latina roots.
Boyle Heights is so stunning and such a gorgeous backdrop and such a beautiful community.
America Ferrera is no stranger to East LA's Boyle Heights. The mostly Latino community provided the setting for her first big movie role, Real Women Have Curves.
A woman has thoughts, ideas, a mind of her own.
Nearly two decades later, she's back as executive producer for a new Netflix series created by two young Latino writers. Gentefied follows three Mexican-American cousins trying to save their family's taco shop as rising rent prices threaten to drive them out of the neighborhood.
We're not going to save the shop with a burrito. We're going to save it with some changes.
Gentefied is gentrification, so it's kind of progress in a neighborhood, but by the people who are from there.
We met up with Ferrera at the restaurant that serves as the taco shop's exterior.
I really saw my experience and my identity struggles in what they had written.
I would imagine that's what drew you to the project then.
Absolutely. The kind of push and pull of gentrification, of, you know, progress and the tension that that creates with roots and with history is sort of an issue that I've lived with internally my whole life.
Ferrera grew up in Southern California wanting to fit in, but also craving a connection to her Honduran heritage.
My genuine heart's desire is to tell stories that haven't been told. We learn to see ourselves in Tom Hanks and Julia Roberts, or whoever you have, but there's no reason why we can't also have genuine, authentic reflections of who we really are.
That authenticity came in part by forming ties with the people of Boyle Heights.
We started building relationships with organizers and activists and organizations here in the community before we came in and started shooting.
The show chronicles gentrification in a neighborhood already facing its own real-life transformation.
It's a very contentious issue, particularly right here in Boyle Heights.
Was that something that you guys took into account as you were putting the show together, the idea that there would be pushback from the people that lived here?
Absolutely. Does it help to talk about this issue, to spotlight Boyle Heights? Does it hurt, you know? And I think that those questions are all very alive and explored in the series.
Landlords like to pull this scare tactic often.
Ferrera has a cameo in the show, but her main role is behind the scenes, directing and producing.
It's hard to get stories about people like us made.
Like us as in?
As in Latinos. And then to get those stories told by us is very, very uncommon. To get to tune into this series and see a whole brand new cast full of incredible talent, that's a win. You know, it doesn't have to be tuned in to see America Ferrera, the only Latina you see in, you know, in a car, or one of the five. Like, that's boring.
The 35-year-old, now pregnant with her second child, is mindful about the society she wants her kids to grow up in.
My desire is to raise my children to love who they are and to love everything about who they are and let their natural, innate love of themselves and love of others be what guides them.
She hopes the show will create a world where Latinos feel empowered both on and off screen.
So we made this show to appeal to a very specific audience. An audience like ourselves who very rarely get to see ourselves on screen. I think Tom Hanks and Julia Roberts should tune in and see themselves in me and in the people I grew up with.
For CBS This Morning, Mireya Villarreal.
That's a beautiful piece.
Bravo, yeah. Bravo.
It's so great many to people, see shows like that being made now.
Yes, happening in every city in America. We know her as Ugly Betty so many people. Now she's an EP. We like it.
We like that.
Bravo.